Shri Anandamayi Mata Ki Jai. In the afternoon, sitting near Ma, I again raised the topic of Diksha, which had been discussed yesterday. I said, Ma, yesterday you divided initiation into three categories, namely supreme or ultimate initiation, medium initiation, and general initiation. Ma, yes, this division was more or less according to the final results obtained by initiation. However, Diksha may of course be of many different kinds. Question: what is meant by Diksha with mantra, Sabij Diksha, and Diksha without mantra, Nirbij? Ma, this may also be called initiation without form, Nirakar Diksha, and initiation with form, Sakar. Or one may also look upon the former as initiation without a mantra, by which the disciple gets rid of his conditioning and is established in the supreme state. Here, all the inherent tendencies and inclinations of the disciple are washed away and obliterated, and he is established in his true self. The ultimate aim of initiation by mantra is also the same, but here the disciple is guided through stages of worshipping a form or deity to the completely unconditioned state. Question: if all sanskaras are extinguished entirely through initiation without mantra, how then can the relationship of generations of gurus and disciples have been established? Ma, in what is called the supreme state or self-realization, nothing at all is destroyed. I have already explained to you that in this exalted state, it cannot be said what remains and what does not remain. Question: Ma, now you have touched upon a very controversial subject. So far as the state of realization of the infinite is concerned, we cannot form any clear idea of anything in particular. So it is better to deal with one aspect at a time. I understand that everything is possible in the state of self-realization. But leaving this aside, please do tell us something about how successive generations of gurus are established. Is there no sanskara or desire at the root of this creation of a traditional order? Ma, you may remember that during yesterday's discussion, I said that in some people, a lingering desire for acquiring reputation or praise remains dormant. And later, this trend manifests in various ways. It may also happen that whatever is caused by samadhi is present in a person, yet none of it is exhibited outwardly. All the inward action of samadhi is quietly taking place, yet it cannot be perceived outside. That is to say, the body is not in any way incapacitated and lying motionless due to samadhi, as is ordinarily the case. Elsewhere, on the other hand, such bodily signs are indeed exhibited. The reason for this is that the desire for acquiring status and praise, which is present in a certain